Welcome guys to another episode here at Orthoflix. My name is Harry for those who don't know me. And today we have an important topic we want to discuss. Everyone is familiar with this song, Wash Your Hands with Soap and Water. This is so much different with what most of you are used to. What we call wet and dash. You just wet your hands for 6 seconds and you dash. That's not the appropriate way to do it. We have to wash our hands for at least 20 seconds. Underscoring the value of washing your hands with soap and water. That's why today we want to talk about the power behind washing your hands with soap and water to prevent entry or infection from coronavirus. Stay here and get informed. Let's get started. The single most important song healthcare providers have dedicated to us to help us stay safe from COVID-19 is this one, Wash Your Hands with Soap and Water. In final analysis, it's the hands. The hands are the connecting piece. They carry pathogens from one place to another. The truth is that you can't control what you touch. You can't control who else touched it. But you can look after your own hands. Hand washing with soap and water is far more powerful weapon against pathogens than many of us may realize. This is what happens. It actually works on two fronts. The first thing that is happening is that you are physically removing debris from your hands. For the same time, for certain agents, the soap will actually be busting open that agent and breaking it apart. Coronaviruses that have left many people infected by COVID-19 is encased in a lipid layer, basically made of fat. So soap can break the fat apart, making the virus unable to infect you. The other thing that soap does is mechanical. It makes the skin slippery, so that with enough rubbing, we can pry off the germs and rinse them away. It sounds so pretty simple, but the vast majority of people don't do it right. In reality, most people are used to wetting their hands without using soap. You wet your hands for 6 seconds and you think you have washed your hands. This move has been referred to by researchers as splash and dash. That's not good enough, especially if you're trying to keep yourself from getting sick. With the new virus on the loose, the stakes are higher. It's time to bring your techniques up to speed. How then? Well, turn on your water, whether cold or hot. A research was done on temperature of water, and it was concluded that temperature doesn't matter in terms of effectiveness. Second, lather up. The soap helps germs slip off your skin as you rub your hands together. If you're in control of the soap that you're using, you may want to pick a liquid or gel soap over foaming soap. In a study that was done in 2017 comparing the effectiveness of liquid soap and foam soap of the same brand, it was found out that using foam soap did significantly reduce bacteria in people who were involved in the study. On the other hand, liquid soap did. People tend to wash their hands in a shorter duration. Participants in the study only used 6 seconds. Sadly, this is the average time most of us spend washing our hands, which is less than 20 seconds that is recommended by the CDC. What about the use of bar soap? Studies have found out that bacteria tend to stay on wet bar soaps because of the frequent use. The bacteria are not transferable to the next user. So if your bar is slim, try to rinse it in water before you lather it on your hands and try to store it so that it can be dry between uses. At the bottom line, just use what you have. Something is better than nothing. So for how long should you wash your hands? The CDC recommends that you should wash your hands for at least 20 seconds. Pay attention to areas in your hands that you might not always think of. Ensure that you keep your nails short so that you can get a good time and ample time to wash your hands properly. Difficult areas where people tend to forget to wash are the posterior aspect of the hand, the lower palm, and you might see fluorescence around your fingernails and the nail bed area where people typically don't wash well. And finally, you have to dry your hands. Paper towels have a beneficial effect beyond simply just washing your hands. Wrapping your hands with paper towel removes more germs compared to washing hands alone. Also, dry hands are less likely to transmit contamination compared to wet hands. The remaining question that we need to ask ourselves is that, how often should I wash my hands? The answer is a lot. The CDC recommends that you should wash your hands, especially in these instances: before, during, and after food prep, before eating, before and after tending to someone who is sick, before and after treating a cut or other wound, after going to the washrooms or restrooms, after blowing your nose, cough or sneeze, after touching an animal or touching pet food or pet waste, after handling pet food or pet treats, after touching garbage, and lastly, immediately you enter your house, because you can pick the virus from anywhere. Can't wash, please reach for hand sanitizer. Lipid-bound membrane viruses like coronaviruses are killed by alcohol-based hand sanitizers. Just make sure it's at least 62% alcohol. Make sure that you use enough so that it can cover all surfaces of your hands. Rub until your hands feel dry. This should take at least 20 seconds. If you still have some debris on your skin after all this washing, ensure that it's cleaned. Use clean paper towels to handle or open bathroom doors. Disinfect dirty surfaces that you use every day, like the touchscreen of your phone and the keyboard of your computer. My conclusion, stay safe, observe proper hand hygiene, and follow all the directives put about by the relevant authorities and various health organizations. Thank you.